Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, you imported 3D geometry into Flame and rebuilt a scene coming from Maya 2018.1. You enabled image-based lighting, as well as textured models with procedural physical-based materials. The camera animation was also edited, and this got you closer to the completed result. However, issues with the geometry, UV maps, as well as changes during production require you to round trip back to Maya to make the changes. The Flame 3D composite was exported as an FBX, and in this video, you'll import it into Maya and make the necessary tweaks and fixes. If you would like to follow along, please go to the previous video to download the media and start from there. In Maya 2018.1, start off in a fresh scene and click the File menu. Choose Import. Ensure the file type is set to FBX. If this is not available, please ensure that you enabled the FBX support through the Preferences Plugin Manager. Navigate to the FBX that was exported by Flame. Select the file and look at the Options panel. Scrolling through the list, you will get all the data and settings how to handle the FBX, and at the very bottom is the FBX version. As a reminder, please ensure that you use a FBX version that is compatible with your 3D application. Click the Import button, and Maya will rebuild the 3D scene. Looking at the outliner on the left, you will see all the objects that were embedded in the FBX. You have the original action camera, the modified camera with the tracking move, an axis with an image surface, and the 3D logo. So there are all the same components that are present in Flame. Now let's view this 3D scene correctly. In the main viewport, click the panel's pull-down menu, choose Perspective, and select Camera 2. If you scrub the time bar, you get the camera result matching Flame. As an optional extra, you can enable the resolution gate on the view to see the final framing. As a tip, if you don't need the original action camera and its target, just delete them out of the scene to eliminate unnecessary objects. Now the models already have textures applied from Flame, so enable the Texture button in the viewport. The textures assigned in Flame are all applied to the models, and the background image is a static frame from the original movie file. So quite a bit of information has come across from Flame via FBX. The only thing that does not come across in this instance is the IBL, which is not supported by the FBX. In Flame, the IBL was set using the Stingray Skydome texture, and this is the default pre-convoluted IBL that is used with Maya when it comes to physical-based materials or PBR textures. Hence why I chose that specific IBL if you want the exact same lighting in Maya. Now the textures were procedurally generated in Flame, and as part of the FBX export, these textures were baked down to OpenEXRs. So if you go to the Windows pull-down menu and choose Rendering Editors, you can select the Hypershade Material Editor. Hovering over the material, the tooltip tells you that this is a Stingray PBS material. Calling up the contextual menu and exposing the graph network displays the pipeline to build this PBR texture. Please note that when you select any of the texture components, they are using the baked OpenEXRs created by Flame. So these maps are no longer procedural. Secondly, if you select the material shader, the panel will show you the shader properties, as well as the maps that are being used. All the Flame shader node values should match the ones here to maintain metadata between the applications. In terms of the linear color management, I suggest checking the base color maps and setting them to linear. To do this, click the Open Shader Effects menu. Locate and select the Base Color Map node in the flow graph. In the Color Map encoding, change the setting from sRGB to Linear Color. You may need to repeat the same steps for all the Stingray PBS textures in the 3D scene. You should see a shift in color when you make this adjustment. Once you have finished adjusting the textures, close the Hypershade editor. Now let's tackle the UV issue with one of the 3D objects. Change the panel to a perspective view and orbit the view to look at the blue disk. The textured dots should be circular and not oval. This is caused by the UVs of the geometry, and you can quickly fix this in Maya. Select the disk in the viewport and choose the UV pull-down menu, UV Editor. Click the Textures menu and enable the Normals map. So the texture map has round dots, but you need to scale the object's UVs to match. Call up the contextual menu over the object and choose UV shells. Drag a box selection over the UV shell of the disk. Switch to the scale menu with the R keyboard shortcut and scale the UVs horizontally until the dots are circular. Once you are done, close the UV editor and the texture looks much better. Call up the contextual menu over the disk and choose Object Mode. Now the disk is a very low poly shape, and you can see this here and in flame. Let's quickly smooth out the geometry to add more detail and give it a cleaner look. Switch to the Modeling Toolkit menu and click Smooth under the Mesh options. Set the divisions to 2. Deselect the model and orbit around the result. This will be fine for this example. Switch the view back to Camera 2 through the Perspective menu. Actually, just rename Camera 2 to Main. You'll see that update in Flame when the FBX is re-exported and sent back. Finally, the producers decided they wanted round rings instead of octagonal. So select one of the rings, and in the Modeling Toolkit, click Smooth. Set the divisions to 4. Repeat the same steps with the other rings. Now you could carry on making changes, but that's all we need for this example. The last step is to export the 3D scene back out as an FBX so that it can be loaded back into Flame. So click on the File menu and choose Export All. Ensure the file type is set to FBX and navigate to the directory for the file and give the FBX a name. In the Options panel, you can go through all the various options to set up your FBX, but normally the default settings are fine for most cases. Towards the bottom of the list, you will find the FBX file format, and you can choose the version that is compatible with Flame. The Flame 2018.3 update supports FBX 2018 and versions below. Click Export All, and Maya creates the FBX file. In the next video, you'll round trip back to Flame and re-import the FBX into a fresh action composite to see the outcome. Please move on to the next video. Don't forget to also check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.